Hi, today I have two questions for you with multiple choice answers. So you may stop video here, try to choose the correct answer, and then you can compare your answer with my answers and explanations. So here is the first question. Which of the following occurs at the ribosomes? And answer A, most of the cell's DNA molecules are stored there, is not correct because most of the DNA molecules stored in the nucleus, and some of them also present in the mitochondria. Mitochondria, of course, much smaller than nucleus, so I drew them out of the proportions, but you should understand this. So we can cross out answer A. It is not correct. And we left with B and C. Answer C, message RNA are produced there, and it's not correct because ribosomes use message RNA in order to translate this message RNA into the protein sequence. So we can cross out answer C, and correct answer would be B, proteins are produced there. And now we can go to the second question. Each tRNA anticodon has three bases. The three base combinations are codes for attracting specific kinds of. And answer A, endoplasmic reticula. Imagine that this is once again a nucleus, and it's surrounded by endoplasmic reticulum that can be of the two kinds, smooth and rough, but no matter smooth or rough, there is ribosomes here that serves for production of the proteins. So this is incorrect answer, so we can cross it out, and we left with B and C. And ribosomes, the question, we can rephrase, does tRNA attract ribosomes? And this is exactly opposite what happens. So imagine that this is ribosome and this is large. A ribosome consists of two parts. This is going to be large and small part, and here would be message RNA, and large part, I want to redraw it like this. Large part consists of the two sites inside, A and P sites, and which attracts tRNA. So here is a tRNA. I will draw it as a clover form, and here going to be 5' end and 3' end, and here going to be anticodon site that consists of three nucleotides. For example, these three nucleotides can be A. So on the message RNA, this should be codon that's going to be U. And also I want to mention that this position here at the last position at the tRNA anticodon site is wobble position. So any in most cases any nucleotide can present here, and you may also ask why do I know that this is last codon of the last nucleotide of the anticodon and not the first one. And this is because I know that here is a 3' end and this is 5' end. 5' end a little bit shorter than 3' end. And if I know where 5 and 3' end on the tRNA, I can also put 5 prime end here, and if we stretch tRNA, for example, if this go here, so we know that here would be 3 prime end of the tRNA if we would stretch it imaginatively. So here would be 5 prime end of the tRNA. So here is going to be 3 prime end of the message RNA, and this is also going to be 3 prime end of the anticodon and 5 prime end of the anticodon. So this goes in antiparallel to message RNA, so this side should be this particular nucleotide should be the last one in the anticodon site. And as you see, now we know that if it is here 5 prime end, ribosome should move from 5 prime end to the 3 prime end direction. So this is direction which ribosome moves. And here would be the first site for the tRNA, where it moves, and it moves to this second site, and then would be released. So here on my picture, we see tRNA that already released. And as you see from these drawings, actually ribosome serve as attraction for the tRNAs, but not vice versa. So we can cross out answer B, and what we left is C amino acid, because when this tRNA would be released, it's once again would be charged with a specific amino acid. So amino acid would attach here, and I also want just to mention that not only anticodon sites specify this amino acid, but also let me draw here is a picture. So this is once again our tRNA. This is claviform. And once again, here is 5 prime end, 3 prime end, and this is going to be the loop here, and this one, and here is going to be anticodon loop. And anticodon going to be here, as in our example, this could be AAA. And here going to be a variable arm. And this is going to be T C arm and loop. So I just want to mention that here, for example, on the D loop, there can be present some sites. Let me choose the other color. Here can be present such sites where nucleotides variable. Also, such variable nucleotides present at the anticodon loop, and the whole variable arm is sometimes can present and sometimes can be absent, and all the or most of the nucleotides that present here is also variable. as long as some variable nucleotides can be present at the TPCC loop. So the whole structure of the tRNA, not only anticodon site designate which amino acid would attach here, but also other structures of the tRNA also important. So our answer would be C, but I just want you to know that not only anticodon site specifies which amino acid would attach to the 3' prime end. So I hope you were able to learn something new today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe to my channel. New videos almost every day. Please ask questions. I will try to answer all those questions. Goodbye.